Halfway between Hampton and Manchester, Sandown, New Hampshire is a town that's easily overlooked, but it rewards a visit, especially if you put Zorvino vineyards on the itinerary.
My dad always enjoyed wine. It was sort of a hobby is how it started, that pretty much just exploded in every way.
Zorvino ships in grapes from California, South America, and South Africa, but they also have 2,200 vines of their own. Wine director, Tom Zack.
We make over 35 different kinds of wines here. We're really known here for our fruit wines.
Where do we start?
We start to talk.
Nancy Walton took me through a tasting.
Everything that we make is 100% the grape. If it's Merlot, it's 100% Merlot grape. Sauvignon Blanc, 100% Sauvignon Blanc grape.
That is sweet, but very grapey.
Yeah, yeah. That's the only way I know how to describe it. It's grapey. All right, Anthony, we're going to finish off with a little bubbly.
This
is our very first sparkling wine.
Wow.
Amore Frizzante. This is a Riesling blended with cherry.
Cheers. Oh, that goes down easy.
A little bit too easy.
Yeah, that's really good.
For those who like pushing the flavor envelope, there's Z Wine Labs.
The idea is very short run wines, very different. Maybe we do 10 to 20 cases only. Very unusual things such as scorpion pepper infused pineapple wine, coffee infused Cabernet. Just a lot of buzz about it.
Zorvino is also popular for functions, hosting more than 100 weddings a year. During the off season, there are wine dinners and other themed parties.
People that come here for a tasting get here and find that this is a beautiful place to have a wedding or a special event, and vice versa. My mom's here on weekends in the tasting room. She loves greeting people and doing tastings, and my father is a fixture. Even when he's not here, everywhere you look is bits of him.
That's no exaggeration. A master craftsman, Amy's father, Jim, made just about every wooden element at Zorvino.
This is a family-owned business, and there's a lot of pride in this facility. We do wine tastings 7 days a week, and you can take a tour of the property as well, and we let people wander through the vineyards as well. You could spend a day here if you wanted to.
All that sipping had me looking for a snack. Down the road, my prayers were answered at St. Julian Macaroons.
Macaroons are a baked confection. They're not quite a cookie, not quite a candy. They're crushed almonds and sugar, egg white, a little honey, vanilla, natural flavoring. That's it.
Naturally gluten-free, this sweet treat doesn't go directly to the waistline.
There's only 3.5 grams of fat for 3 macaroons, and that fat is all coming from the almonds themselves, so it's the good healthy fat.
Using a recipe from 17th century France, Price whips up more than 900 macaroons on bake days.
We do 6 small batches. You can't do a large batch because the egg white is the only thing that makes the macaroon rise. They get packed up and they ship out frozen, and they can be thawed and refrozen over and over without harm. Maintains the crunchy on the outside, chewy on the inside, and that rich almond flavor.
Price says they'll last up to 2 years in the freezer.
If you put them out on a plate for a few minutes at room temperature, they'll thaw, you know, 3 with tea. If you just put them out while the kettle boils, they'll be ready to enjoy.
Sandown is home to what is thought to be New Hampshire's first labor strike. In 1773, workers were paid in rum while they built this meeting house. When the rum ran out, they put down their tools and stacked their timbers until that supply was replenished.
The old meeting house isn't the only piece of Sandown history that's still standing. The Sandown Depot, built in 1874, is now home to a railroad museum. Curator Jonathan Wells.
In the heyday, this line went all the way from Worcester through Nashua up to Rochester and on to Portland. Single track railroad, unsignaled. It was said to be the busiest railroad in the country.
Open Saturdays from 10 to 2, spring through fall, the museum greets visitors with an old flanger car out front.
There's a lot of history in here pertaining to the town and the railroad. The ladies' waiting room has a lot of local Sandown artifacts in it. This was called the operator's bay. The station master in charge, this would have been his office, where he would receive train orders, telegraph messages.
Lining the walls of the men's waiting area are old track charts engineers used to navigate the Worcester to Portland line.
It starts at the top with the milepost. The line right here is the curvature. The most important is down here are the grades.
And now you know a little about Sandown. perhaps enough to put it on your own list for a tank away.
What a pretty place. Mm. And back to St. Julian's Macaroons, you can't just drop in.
And they don't really have a retail operation. As they say, we're a very small, family-run business. Most of their business goes through online or phone orders, mm-hmm. so they're not always there. So they encourage you to stop by, mm-hmm. but call first and make sure they're there. They'd love to greet you, but they might not be there if you just swing by.
A town for all ages is next.
So Chow's from the Andes Mountains.
A long trip for a chinchilla.